children, welcome back to another video. This is teacher Siddha Gurge inviting you to another video in geography. Now today we are going to do the hill states of North India part 2. In the earlier video we have done Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, these two union territories. So now in this video we are going to do the hilly states, that is Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So hope all of you are doing the work which is said. Now I start with Himachal Pradesh. Now the key concepts which we are going to learn today are the life in the hilly states, since these are the hilly states of North India, occupations, the festivals, the culture, the way the people live, the food and the places of tourist interest. Now first we go to Himachal Pradesh. So children, you can open your atlas, and by now all of you must be knowing the capital. Yes, right, the capital is Shimla, and the languages spoken there are Hindi, which is our national language, as well as Pahadi. Now Pahadi is the language which is spoken in the hilly states, in the hilly areas of Himachal Pradesh. Next we come to occupation, which is growing of crops, and people here are skilled weavers, that is weaving. They like to weave clothes and shawls. Next, the food. Now people are foodies. Everywhere people are foodies. You and me, we all are foodies. We like to eat. Now the special dishes of the Himachal Pradesh, or the people of Himachal Pradesh, are dum, which is beans with curd. You can see the picture here. You can see the beans. And the next picture is cha gosht. Gosht means mutton. Mutton with curds. So these are the delicacies of the Himachal people. Next we come to the rivers. Now the rivers which flow through the Himalayas. Now the rivers which flow through the Himalayas are, you can see, you can open your atlas to the physical map of India and you can locate these rivers. River Jhelum, River Satluj, River Chenab, Ravi and Bees. So these are the rivers. I repeat again, Satluj here, then Ravi, Chenab and Bees. So these are the rivers which flow through Himachal Pradesh, and they generate or they give a lot of water to the hilly states. Next is the dress. The men wear loose coats which are called cholas. You can see this man wearing a chola and an embroidered cap. So the speciality of Himachal is the embroidered cap. Then you can see the women, they will wear the kurta pajama. Here you can see a lady even wearing a sort of a long dress, and in the other picture you can see her wearing kurta pajama, a scarf and a lot of jewelry. So the women are fond of jewelry. So they like to wear a lot of silver or oxidized jewelry. Next we go to the valleys. Now Himachal Pradesh has a lot of valleys. So the valley is nothing but the low-lying space between two hills or two mountains, which you have already learnt. So the famous valley in the Himachal is Kulu and Kangra. So in the first picture you can see the Kulu Valley, and in the second picture you can see the Kangra Valley. So these valleys are very very beautiful, and most of the people come here to spend their holidays in these beautiful valleys. Crops. So we all know the crops which we eat, all of us, wheat, maize and potato are a very important crops, as well as the fruits like apples, apricots and cherries. Now in Himachal you will find orchards of these fruits like apples, cherries and apricots. Now, if you visit this place, you can just go and even pluck an apple. So if you go to these orchards, you can just pluck an apple and you can eat it also. The folk dance. The folk dance of Himachal is Nati. So you can see these two pictures. In one picture, you can see the man, and in the other picture, you can see women performing the folk dance of Himachal Pradesh, that is Nati. And you can see the women in their beautiful costumes. They really look beautiful, isn't it? Yes, right. Festival. Most important festival is Dashera. Now, Dashera is the festival which is celebrated all over India in different ways. It is the coming of Lord Rama back to his kingdom. So, the people celebrate it in different ways. Now, here in Himachal Pradesh, the Dashera is celebrated in the picture how you see it. So, it is celebrated in a different way. Next, we go to the handicrafts. Now, the main handicrafts of Himachal Pradesh are toy making, wood carved articles and shawls. In the first picture, you can see the toys. You can see the masks. In the second picture, you can see the carved furniture. You can see a table which is carved and it really looks beautiful. And the third picture shows you the beautiful shawls. So these are hand woven shawls. So the people are skilled weavers and they weave these shawls. Places of tourist interest. Now, since Himachal Pradesh is very famous for its scenic beauty, so most of the hill stations are in Himachal Pradesh. So to name a few, Kullu Manali, you can see the picture, Dharamshala, Dalhousie. So these are the hill stations. Now, Kufri, can you see this picture, children? Kufri, this is a very important place in Himachal where most of the tourists enjoy the snow. So that is a lot of activities take place there, like ice skating, skiing takes place in this place called Kufri in Himachal Pradesh. In the next slide, you can see the Buddhist monastery. So Himachal Pradesh is famous for a lot of Buddhist monasteries. So you can see a picture of a Buddhist monastery. And last year is another very important tourist destination, which is called Spiti Valley. So most of the tourists visit this valley for its scenic beauty and for its pleasant weather. Next we go, oh wow, can you identify the great leader in this picture? Yes, right. It is Dalai Lama. So he is the world's spiritual leader. Now, Dalai Lama has got his residence in Himachal Pradesh, in Kasauli. The place is called Kasauli. And in the picture, you can see the residence of Dalai Lama. Next, we go to, okay, now with this, we have finished with Himachal Pradesh. So children, see, you need to know a few things of all the states. Now, Himachal Pradesh, I have tried to make it as short as possible so that you know outside the textbook, you need to know a lot of things. Now, your textbook is like a guideline for you. Understood? But there are many other things which you can learn beyond your textbook. So that is why teacher takes a lot of trouble to prepare this PPT or presentation for you. So this is about Himachal Pradesh. Now next we go to the next state in the hilly states, that is Uttarakhand. Okay, now we go to the next state, that is Uttarakhand. Now Uttarakhand is another hilly state which lies in the northern part of India. So here we will see the key concepts, life in the hilly states, the occupations, the food, the dress, the culture and the places of tourist interest. So everything basically is the same, the concepts are the same, But the life in this state is different from Himachal Pradesh. So first we will see what is the capital of Uttarakhand. So the capital is Dehradun. So Dehradun is the capital of Uttarakhand. The languages spoken are Garhwali and Kumaoni. Now these two, Garhwali and Kumaoni, are the local languages or languages which are spoken in the hilly areas, whereas Hindi is also spoken, which is our national language. Occupations: farming and weaving, growing of crops and weaving clothes, shawls. Rivers. Now the tributaries of River Ganga. Now River Ganga flows through Uttarakhand. So I have made, there's a small map here. You can open your atlas and you can locate the tributaries of River Ganga. So the River Ganga splits into different branches and those are called the tributaries. Now the tributaries are Alaknanda, Bhagirathi and Yamuna. If you open your physical map of India, you can locate these three tributaries, that is Alaknanda, Bhagirathi and Yamuna. Next we go to the crops. Crops are potato and maize. And the traditional food. Wow, lovely food. Now, the main food of Uttarakhand is kafuri. Now, kafuri is a dish which is made out of spinach and fenugreek leaves. So, we all know what is spinach and fenugreek is methi. You must have heard about methi, parathas and all. So, now, this is the dish which is called kafuri, which is made out of spinach and fenugreek leaves. Next dish is, people consume a lot of black gram. So they make dal out of black gram. So these two dishes are very famous in this region, that is Uttarakhand. Next we go to the trees and the vegetation. So what type of trees? Now being a hilly area, most of the trees are coniferous trees. Now in the first picture you can see pine and you can see the pine cones also. See children, you can have a closer look, you can see the cones, then you can see the deodar tree and then you can see the chestnut. You can see the flowers and inside is the chestnut fruit. So these are the trees which grow in Uttarakhand. Dress. Women wear the ghagra, the kameez or the salwar and a dupatta. You can see the picture. In the first picture, the women are wearing a ghagra, they are wearing a kameez, that is, they wear a salwar and a dupatta. That is, they wear a blouse, a kameez and they wear the ghagra and they take a dupatta. They are fond of jewelry also. In the next picture, you can see men wearing a kurta and a pajama or a churi pant. A churi pant you can see in the picture there, along with a cap. So this is the traditional attire or the dress of the people of Uttarakhand. Now, Uttarakhand is famous for lakes. There are a lot of lakes in Uttarakhand, but most important is the Rup Kund and the Kedar Tal. So Rup Kund is a lake and Kedar Tal is also an important lake in Uttarakhand. Now if you want to locate these, you can go to the map of Uttarakhand. You can go to the open to the atlas and you can go into the map of Uttarakhand and you can locate these two lakes. Whatever pertaining Uttarakhand, you can look into your atlas, just open to Uttarakhand. You can locate these things there. Valley. Uttarakhand is very famous for valley. Now all of you know what is a valley. The low-lying area between two hills or mountains. The famous valley is the Dune Valley and the Valley of Flowers. Now this Valley of Flowers is very famous for different species of flowers. different varieties of flowers grow in this valley of flowers. So most of the tourists who visit this place go in for a trek, or they go in for a trekking to see the different flowers. Same thing with this dune valley. A lot of trekking activities also take place in the dune valley. Fruits. Wow, they look so yummy. Apricot, strawberry, now plum. Now you all know apricot, strawberry and plum. Another famous fruit here is called kaffal. Kaffal is nothing but a type of berry. It is a type of berry. So that is kaffal. You can look at the picture. So it looks like a berry. So that is the most important fruit of Uttarakhand. Animals. Now Uttarakhand has a wide forest and you can find a lot of animals like the sloth bear. Can you see the sloth bear? And the musk deer. Now this musk deer is found mostly in the hilly states of North India. So the next animals are the tiger and leopard. The most important is the musk deer and the sloth bear. Dance. Now I have put a lot of folk dances together. So Uttarakhand is very famous for its folk dances. So different types of folk dances. You can see different costumes and the people dancing or performing the folk dances of Uttarakhand. Festivals. Now Makar Sankranti and Ganga Dashera. Now Makar Sankranti is the festival which is celebrated all over India in the month of January, and it is celebrated in different ways. In some parts of India it is celebrated with the activity of kite flying. But here in Uttarakhand, people take a dip in the river Ganga. So that is in the festival of Makar Sankranti, the people take a dip in the river Ganga and they celebrate Makar Sankranti. That is, they pray to the sun god. That is by taking a dip in the Ganga. In the next picture, you can see the Ganga Dashera. So that is how the Dashera is celebrated on the banks of river Ganga, where they have the Ganga Aarti and they celebrate it as Ganga Dashera. So Dashera, you saw the Dashera, how it was celebrated in Himachal Pradesh, and now the Dashera of Uttarakhand. Next two festivals, Holi, the festival of colors, and next is the Kumbh Mela. Now the Kumbh Mela is celebrated after 12 years and it is celebrated in Uttarakhand in a place called Haridwar, where people take a dip in the river Ganga and they celebrate it for many days. So that is the Kumbh. You can see the picture of the Kumbh Mela. Next we come to handicrafts. Now the main handicrafts are the shawls and copperware. And you can see a lot of jewelry in the picture also. So in the first picture you see items of copper. So you get good items or good articles made out of copper. In the second you can see a lot of ceramics. Means a lot of articles made out of ceramic. The third you can see a lot of jewelry which is made out of beads. Then you can see the beautiful shawls or the shawl, and you can see a weaver weaving a basket. So these are the handicrafts of Uttarakhand. Places of tourist interest. So the famous temples of Kedarnath and Badrinath are in Uttarakhand. Now in this picture you can see the temple of Kedarnath, which is the temple of Lord Shiva. Now this temple is open only for 6 months, and during the winter season the temple is fully covered by snow and the temple is closed. Next we go to the Badrinath temple. This temple is very famous. A lot of tourists visit the temple, and it is a beautiful sight also, because to go to Kedarnath and Badrinath, you need to do a lot of trekking. So to reach to these places. Next, you can see the wildlife sanctuary, the Jim Corbett Wildlife Sanctuary, which is very famous in Uttarakhand. And you can see a people taking a safari to spot the Bengal tiger. The famous animal, the Bengal tiger, is very famous in the Jim Corbett Park, and people visit this to see the Bengal tigers. Next, you can see the city of Haridwar, which is situated on the banks of river Ganga. So that is a city where lots of pilgrims visit to take a dip in the waters of river Ganga. So these are the tourist places of Uttarakhand. Next, we come to a very important part, which is called the Chipko movement. Now, Chipko means to hug a tree. Now, this movement was started in Uttarakhand long time back by the tribal women of Uttarakhand. So what they used to do is, when the woodcutters used to come to cut the trees in the forest, so that is the time these people, these tribal women, used to hug the trees, and hugging a tree is called Chipko. In the same way, in the other picture, you can see many of two ladies or two girls putting some posters around a tree to show or to give you the message that trees are not meant to be cut down, but they are meant to be preserved. So they have written there that you cannot cut trees, and you have to, they are hugging the tree. In the next picture also, you can see a lot of tribal women are hugging the trees and not allowing the woodcutters to cut the tree. So the Chipko movement is very famous in this place, Uttarakhand. So with this, I finish the two states of the North India, that is Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So hope, children, you have enjoyed the slides and the video, and with this I take a leave. We'll see you very soon in the next video. Stay home, stay safe.